Before we begin, I want to mention two things. First, you can select your preferred language from the subtitles menu to watch this video in your own language. Second, if you're patient enough to watch the video until the end, you'll find out how you can get a free gift I prepared for you. Let's get started. Let's start with a sketch to create the foundation for our painting. At the very beginning of the process, it's a good idea to lightly sketch our outline with a pencil to define the boundaries of our painting. You can start all your paintings this way. That way, you can easily see where everything is and move more freely during the coloring stage. If you want to see what the finished painting will look like, you can take a look at this reference image. I'm putting it here because when you're painting, constantly referring to the reference image can guide you and help you see what the next step should be as you progress through the stages. And the colors we'll be using today are light green, green, dark green, black, yellow, and white. Now that we're moving on to the coloring stage, let me give you a little tip. As I mentioned, we'll be using light green, green, and dark green. But I'm not using three different green paints. I'm taking one shade of green on my palette and mixing different amounts of water into it to get the shades I want. This is not only a more fun way to paint, but also helps us understand colors better. We never directly apply paint to our canvas or paper after dipping the brush into the paint. This will give a very crude color, only amateurs do that. Since you're here with me, you're no longer an amateur and you won't make amateur mistakes. My preferred method is to fully saturate my brush with water, then pick up the paint and dab it on a rag or paper towel before bringing it to the paper. This way, the excess paint and water are left on the paper towel. But be careful, you don't want to completely dry the brush, just remove the excess. This way, you'll achieve softer, more realistic colors on paper. Don't be afraid, let's try this technique right now. If you can't quite do it or have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask me in the comments section. This is a place where we gather to learn. We wouldn't be here if we already knew everything, would we? And the best way to learn something is by asking questions. I'll always be here to answer your questions. Don't be shy about asking. When we talk about pastel colors, we often hear that they are softer and more pleasing to the eye. But what exactly are pastel colors? Pastel colors are actually less saturated versions of existing colors. Saturation might sound a bit complex, but simply put, it's how vibrant and bright a color is. In pastel colors, this vibrancy is reduced and the colors move closer to white. So the tones we get when we mix a color with white on the color wheel are pastel tones. Let's visualize this on a color wheel. Imagine we want to create a pastel blue. This part of the wheel is pure blue. If we paint with this color, it will be a very harsh blue, which is not what we want. Because in nature, almost nothing is pure blue. But what about the sky? What about the clouds? What about the sea? I can hear you all shouting, let's calm down first. Our eyes perceive the light reflected from objects as color. This means that the colors of objects are actually the lights they reflect from their surroundings. This is called the theory of color relativity. It's a deep topic. But if you're interested and want to learn more, I've left a link to a video in the description that explains this topic very clearly. It's a video I really like and it explains this topic very well. You can watch it there in more detail. Once you understand the theory of color relativity, you'll realize that no color you see is actually the color you think it is. It's a fascinating and fun topic. Another topic I find equally interesting is the use of white in paintings. Did you know that painters have an unspoken rule about not using white paint? I was surprised to when I first heard it. To understand why, I think it's necessary to understand the theory of color relativity. But looking at the painting we're doing now, what I want to say about using white is that we don't have to paint the white parts. I'm surprised myself at how many seemingly absurd, but actually logical things I've been saying today. It's like this, if we have a white paper, why waste our white paint? Even if we paint it, I don't think it will be whiter than the paper. So my suggestion is to leave the white areas of our painting blank and use the whiteness of the paper. So I wanted to keep the nostrils and teeth white in the painting I'm working on. Instead of painting them, I left those parts as they were, using the white of the paper. I carefully painted around them, and now I have these nice, clean white areas. What do you think? Does this technique look good, or should I try something different? When do you think it's best to use the paper's natural whiteness instead of white paint? Share your thoughts in the comments. I'm always open to new ideas. I've noticed something interesting about white paint recently. Have you ever wondered why acrylic paint sets usually come with two white paints? I think it's because white is more than just a color, it's a tool. By mixing white into other colors, we can create endless possibilities. It's like having a secret ingredient that can transform any color. Just like how we can get different shades by sliding a color towards white on a digital palette, we can create a whole range of tones by mixing white into our colors when painting. So, let's appreciate the power of white. Long live white! Of course, we don't always avoid painting with white. For instance, if we're painting a scene with a very shiny object that's directly under a light source, we definitely need to use white to represent the really bright highlights. Or, when we're painting a shiny metal surface, we can use white to show the reflections of light or the overall lighting in the scene. However, if we can't find another way to express something, or if the concept of relative color leads us to white, then I think we should use it. Ultimately, it all comes down to your creativity. Do whatever your imagination and creativity tell you. The most important thing is to be free. I know I've talked a lot, but I get so excited when it comes to colors. If you've made it this far, then we clearly shared that same passion. And since we're on the same page, I have a little gift for those of you who've watched the video this far. I will leave a link below where you can download all the uncolored versions of the drawings from my previous videos, so you can create your own coloring book, color them however you like, and practice. And if you share your finished pieces on Instagram and tag me, I'll share your artwork on my account too. I'd be so happy to know that I've inspired someone. I'm not kidding, I'd be really happy. We're nearing the end of our video. I hope the information I've shared has inspired and motivated you to create. It would make me so happy to know that I've inspired you in any way. Please don't hesitate to share your feedback and ideas. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, happy creating!